Вечер добрый, мы приветствуем вас из студии ТВ Экстра. И у нас на прямой связи Джулия Кеннон и Кая Виттенбург из Америки. Hello, America! Russia is calling. How do you do?
Hello! Being here, Dennis.
Yeah, I'm very glad to see you both. And we miss you, Julia, for 6 years in Russia. How do you do?
Okay, fantastic. And it's been, my gosh, so many things have happened since I was last there. I was there with my mother, Dolores Cannon. And, lots happened. So that's kind of what we'll be covering during this talk, some of the things that have kind of shifted and changed so we can keep carrying on the work of my mother. Kaya is probably the biggest thing that happened here to keep this going. If I can tell a little story, it was quite devastating to me, as you can imagine, just as I know the world was devastated when they heard of my mother's passing. And oh my gosh, I just, okay. And I had been, it was kind of hard to keep going at some times. It was like, because I was given all these instructions from them, it's like to do this and this and this and all these different things. And I'm like, I just lost my person that I worked with. I just lost all of this. And I'm like, how do I keep this going? And I need help. I need, all these big assignments. I mean, listen, guys, I didn't expect her to pass. She had me convinced she was going to live forever. Mm. And just like, I didn't expect it, and it was very sudden. And so now it's like regrouping, do everything. And so a lot of changes had to happen there. And I needed help. I needed help on how to get this out there, how to keep going with it, because I was at the end and the limit of what I knew to do. I was always working with mom, and we worked together. We were cohorts, collaborators, and now I'm kind of out there trying to do this on my own, and I didn't know how to do that. And so I was putting it out there. I need help. And then in, it was 2017, magically somebody says, here, I think you might want to meet this person. Just meet him and see what you think. And I think he might could be helpful for QHHT. And so this was through a fellow friend of ours. You might have heard of Suzanne Spooner, probably, Dennis. Have you heard of Suzanne Spooner? She's like the main moderator of the QHHT forum. Yeah. And so she's the one. And if I can tell Kai, she did a session with Kai, and that's how she knew him. And then she's like, Julie, I really think he could help. And so we organized a meeting together, and we just hit it off. It was like, yes, this is it. Now, it was well into 2018, maybe even 19, before I finally figured out that he was the answer to that call I was putting out there. I need help. And he was it. So sometimes it's given to us and we don't understand it yet. We don't see it. But that's where Kaya, he is so great.
One nice spirit realized that he will join to this academy.
Absolutely. And he was, and what was so wonderful is, he came in, he could talk more about what he does with everything, but he helps, strengthen our presence and keep us moving and growing and helping people understand who we are better. He's a strategist, so he knows how to kind of help maneuver everything. This is what we need to do. And those are the things I didn't know how to do. So he brings in what I didn't know how, and then he strengthens the part that I did know how to do. And so it's almost like he brings that element back of this partnership that I had with my mother. Mm. And that is, oh my gosh, that's heartwarming. So everyone, I'd like you to meet. This is Kaya Wittenberg. He's my answer.
Nice to meet you, Kaya, through this online. I would like to ask you, did you ever been to Russia?
Yes. Thank you, everybody. It's so great to meet you. I have been to Russia. I've been to Moscow, St. Petersburg, Ekaterinburg.
Oh.
And Novosibirsk.
You're a traveler.
They're all over Russia. I love Russian culture. My mother's Serbian, so I grew Serbian Orthodox, so I'm very familiar with the Julian calendar and Christmas on different days. And so very familiar with Russian culture, and I connect with it.
Great, great. So you both were in Russia and you realized who is Russians. That's a good start point. I'd like that you will make a kind of together spreading QHTT Academy through the world. So it's kind of, how to say, synchronization. Yeah. And what is your current role in QHTT Academy today, Kaya?
Yes, and today I work on the business in expanding the business of QHHT around the world. So the goal is so that everyone that is out there, they can be aware of QHHT. Mm-hmm. So the general public around the world, they know what QHHT means. And if they have heard the word QHHT, it means they're available to get a session done. And when you get a session done on you, we know that you're capable of transforming your life in such a powerful way. And the more people that can do this, it's really clear, the better that the entire world becomes. So that's really my mission, is getting it so there's a greater sense of awareness where people really understand QHHT as being an option out there, kind of like shining a light, and sometimes in a place that can be kind of dark. Yeah, and I also teach with Julia. Yes.
Yeah, I know that you've got a third level of QHTT, so you understand inside of yourself how it's going on, how it's work, how it's help, and so on. Why it's important to understand how the method is working when you're expanding it through the world?
It's really important to understand how it's working as you expand it, because it's about connecting people to who they really are. And when you know who you really are and you are not afraid to express yourself in terms of who you really are, that's when you can bring a great deal of joy and happiness, and you wake up in the morning and you really feel like you can do something good with this life. And I think it's important for people to kind of wake up, because there's a lot of things going around in this crazy world that can get us looking in a different direction, that can get us feeling down, that can get us feeling in a way that makes us look away from who we really are. And QHHT allows us to get that direct information from your higher self, from the most powerful form of you, and you can get that better than anywhere. And I love psychics, I love astrology, but in those circumstances, someone is telling you about you, someone else is telling you about you. And what drew me to QHHT was you're getting real information from you about you. And I had never discovered anything like that previously. And that's what made it so special and powerful. And that's why I decided to apply a lot of my business knowledge into this and drive it. I have quite an extensive background in expanding businesses.
Mm-hmm. I'd like that it's not only the business, but it's helpful business. I would like to ask Julia, how do you understand how the Kaya is keep going well, I mean, as QHT instructor or a regression therapist?
It is going excellent. I mean, this partnership that we've created is just, it's beyond my greatest hopes. We work so well together. When we do a class together, it feels like I've got mom back.
Yeah.
That's how good a partnership it is. I mean, we work so well together. I feel like, I really feel like mom's.
Could I say a kind of twin souls?
Definitely I think we had a plan. We made a plan to come together to do this. It might have been orchestrated by my mother. I don't know. in there, but definitely, I feel like it wasn't by chance. That's for sure. This is like a big deal, and we both see it as a big mission that we have, that we're doing. So I really feel like this was a planned event that we created before we ever got here.
You told us that the mission, it's to expand the knowledge QHT methods through the world. And how many people got level first or second right now? And why it's so important for people?
Well, as far as the numbers, I think that on our website, I think we have like 6,000 practitioners, but it's probably more than that. That's how many are actually where they can be listed. We have many that are like in parts where they're not listed yet. You have to get so many qualifications kind of mm-hmm. thing before you're listed on the site to be mm-hmm. available for the public to see you to do sessions. So would you say maybe 10,000, Kaya? Are we probably?
I would say more than that, because there's a lot of people that take the class and, you know, they don't take it all the way through. So a lot of people, maybe for every four people that take the class, you mm-hmm. know, one person goes all the way through and is on the site and doing mm-hmm. everything. So some people, they just want to learn it out of curiosity, and it's a skill, and some other people want it to be a career. It can be anything for anyone. What I do know is that we average about 100,000 visitors a month to our website. Mm-hmm. So that's a lot of people from all over the world coming to your website to get information about QHHT.
Yeah, but could you explain a little bit more why it's so interesting? I mean, this method, how it works, how it can be used for your personal life and for life for your close connection.
I think the reason it's the people are really enjoying it, what they see in it and everything, is exactly what Kaya was saying, as far as you are getting your own information. You are finding out who you really are, and it's from yourself. It's from that part of you that has all that information. I mean, there's nothing quite like that. When you are able to see these things and you're able to understand how they relate to your life, and all this information is coming in that makes perfect sense. I mean, it becomes crystal clear what you need to do. Like I was saying, it transforms your life, because you get like a roadmap almost, because you're shown these things in such clarity, and it makes this life make so much sense. And now you know what to do going forward. And so I really feel like that is like first. And then second is, because you make this connection in the session, mm-hmm. now what we are finding is then people are able to, they know what that session, that connection feels like. So now they can do it in a conscious state and just connect anytime. And that's what we are told by the higher self, the SC, that's what we're told that they want us to do. This is our time to connect, make this connection, make it, you know, you are the one with the answers. You know, we've heard that so many times. All of the answers lie within. So it's just showing people how to do that and do it on their own and not be reliant on other people all the rest of their lives.
Kaya, nowadays there are many popular methods of regression techniques. Why methods founded by Dolores is so topical today? What is your opinion?
The thing that I find fascinating about QHHT and Dolores' technique that's different is that it allows you to work in the deepest state, the deepest state of regression. There's many other forms of hypnosis that you can do that can give you results, but those are mostly working in a state called the alpha state, which is a lighter state of hypnosis. And the induction doesn't take very long at all. In fact, we go in and out of the alpha state often when we're driving down the road, and we can just be staring off and listening to music or watching TV and seeing a commercial. We find ourselves going into alpha state. We do it all the time. But to get into theta state, that state right before you go to sleep, when you feel like maybe you're awake but asleep, and right before when you wake up, when you're maybe am I awake? Am I dreaming? It's hard to tell. QHHT is able to work in that state, but instead of only feeling it for 30 seconds or 20 seconds, we're able to work within it for 2 hours. And it's in that state where you have access to all the information about who you are, who you've ever been, and who you ever will be. And for me, that is incredibly powerful, because if you're going to spend the time to work in a different state, why not work in the most powerful altered state? It's don't waste your time. Just go in for the most powerful thing. It'll take you longer to learn. There's a little lot more that goes into it. But once you go into it and you get through it, you'll get the greatest results, because it has the most powerful potential within that state called the theta brainwave frequency.
Do you often have a regression session now? I mean, do you practice?
All the time. We're always practicing. Yeah. We practice on each other. We're able to get in and out of this state really easily. So when we're teaching, we're often having the students do sessions on us in front of the class and as examples. And then we do it for fun too, just to predict the future and, mm-hmm. you know, learn new things about each other and ourselves and who we've been.
So a kind of progression, you mean?
Yes.